when Tony Stark built his first Iron Man suit, he had a cave, a box of scraps, and a genius-level intellect. When Kantanka decided to follow suit, literally, he had a backyard, some tinfoil, and a dream. The result? The Kantanka Exoskeleton. A suit that looks like Iron Man's awkward third cousin, who flunked out of superhero school. If you've ever wondered what happens when you mix overconfidence with a toolbox of spare parts, this is it. Let's dive into this metallic misadventure and explore the armor, the weapons, and the movement that makes Kantanka's creation a masterpiece of comedy. Let's start at the top, literally. Westark gave us sleek titanium helmet with integrated HUD display. Kantanka decided a motorcycle helmet would do just fine. Yes, the kind you'd use to dodge traffic, not bullets. It's almost charming how much faith he had in that plastic dome. Did he think bullets would politely bounce off like raindrops? Or maybe he assumed his enemies would throw pillows, not grenades. Either way, the helmet is less battle ready and more ready for a light drizzle. It's not just a design flaw, it's an open invitation for a headshot. Oh, but it gets better. The suit's armor completely skips the neck. The most vulnerable part of the human body is left as bare as a sunny beach. If villains don't take him out with a direct punch, even a curious pigeon could do that job. While Iron Man's suit was seamless and protective, Kantanka's creation screams, "Aim here, please!" It's almost considerate, really. He's not just wearing a suit, he's wearing a roadmap for enemy attacks. Watching this suit move is like watching someone walk after eating way too much Thanksgiving dinner. Iron Man's suit could fly, dodge bullets, and even dance. Kantanka's? It waddles like a duck that's just discovered high heels. If you're thinking, well, at least it can run, think again. This suit couldn't outrun a three-legged tortoise on a bad day. Forget high-speed races. This thing's top speed might qualify it for a leisure parade. It's a waste of funds making something impractical like this. It's better to make flying drones armed with bombs than having a soldier wearing an armored exoskeleton walking on the ground waiting to be obliterated. Make sense? Because Kantanka has even made rockets, and it's not the kind of rockets to fly to space, it's rockets that are used in warfare. So I think it's better for Kantanka to just stick with rockets, you know? Building this exoskeleton, I mean, he really did a poor job. Now, Kantanka did try to give his suit some firepower. A couple of cannons strapped to the back. Sounds cool, right? By the time he reaches to grab one, the battle will already be over. And so will he. How are they supposed to aim with those rifles? Because you can imagine aiming a rifle that is on your shoulder without some assistance from something like AI is practically impossible. Yeah? And I'm not expecting those motorcycle helmets to have any kind of AI or even any kind of software. Yeah? And what about reloading? How are you supposed to reload a weapon that's in your shoulder? Because I can imagine by the time you are reloading it, the enemy is already there. You're already dead trying to reload that thing. So how practical is this exoskeleton? Yeah? Is it that Kantanka watched too much Iron Man movie? Was he like obsessed with Iron Man such that he decided to build his own suit? It's as if someone designed the weapons for a person with 6 foot long arms, but forgot to mention it to the user. Iron Man's Jarvis would have automated targeting systems ready for seconds. Kantanka suit? Well, he seems ready to say, good luck buddy, it's been nice knowing you. Okay, one thing you will immediately notice is the wires. They're everywhere, dangling, looping, and looking like the aftermath of a toddler's art and craft session. It's as if the suit itself isn't sure what goes where. You know, it's not only wires that are hanging, but there are these pipes. Are those pipes supposed to be like hydraulic pipes or something? And if they are, why are they hanging, or were they just there for the show? This idea has been copied extremely poorly, you know, because if I'd had to rate this thing, I think I'd give it maybe a 4 over 10. And thanks for trying. So this is not the idea. And putting on a cape does not make you fly. I guess people with common sense would understand. But it's a pretty good armor when you're up against bows and arrows. Because this thing against bullets and modern warfare, I mean, it's basically like wearing a clown suit. Because I don't even think it can protect you from strong winds. And what runs the hydraulic system to support such an exoskeleton of that size? Is it electric, diesel, or gasoline? Nah. I think it runs on hopes and dreams, or maybe black magic. Because obviously the hydraulic system would have to be powered by something. But I guess the hydraulic systems are not powered, because at the end of the day, the pipes that are supposed to be powering the hydraulic systems are the ones that are hanging. And heaven forbid it rains. One drop of water and the whole suit might short circuit. Controlling this exoskeleton is less like piloting a high-tech machine, and more like trying to solve a Rubik's Cube blindfolded. Every movement feels like a debate between man and machine. And guess who's losing? Watching them maneuver is like seeing someone wrestle a shopping cart with a broken wheel. Now, let's be fair. Kantanka tried. I mean, he really did. But if Iron Man saw this, he'd probably have to switch to a villain to put it out of its misery. I guess with this thing, Ghana has killed all its enemies by making people die of laughter. Because what is this? If Kantanka's goal was to make us laugh, he succeeded. And isn't that a superpower by itself? However, this video is awesome for what it presents in terms of possibilities. Imagine if the government was sponsoring this engineering. I mean, this is a great start for Africa. Even though it's not the start that we'd all love, it's something. And it's here.